Welcome everybody in this beautiful sunny day in Davos. Thank you very much for joining our panel. We'll discuss about exciting topic, Quo Vadis Digital Europe and Quo Vadis Fintech Europe, as we decided to share our panel into two parts to cover the general technology development in Europe and also the financial services and insurtech development in Europe. Last year was an amazing year for Europe. As you see, Europe had finished with almost 110 billion euro of exits, very large, very successful IPOs. Spotify, which is the biggest development of European technology since SAP. SAP was over 30 years ago, a global success story. Spotify is coming right now, and that's probably the kind of biggest development in the last 20 years. RDN, another large fintech IPO, which happened in Europe with 18 billion euro valuation. Farfetch and Elasticsearch, that's the four largest technology IPOs, all of them above 5 billion, also very large technology exits. iZettle, which was one of our portfolio companies, being bought by PayPal for $2.2 billion. That was also amazing years for technology exits to the strategic buyers. Looking from the regional perspective, UK and Sweden are driving the European technology ecosystem, both reaching almost 40 billion euro in exits. Surprisingly, Netherlands, which is a relatively small economy, is also doing quite good. 13 billion euro in technology exits by these two companies, which went public. Then the core of European Union, Italy, France, and Germany, is about 40 billion euro. And also a nice surprise, the biggest success story, the biggest technology success story is from Central Eastern Europe, Avast, which is right now the biggest security software company in the world, born in Prague, with 6 billion euro IPO on London Stock Exchange. That's the geographical split of Europe. We did 110 billion euro of transactions versus US 136 billion euro and China 130 billion, which is the first time what's happened in Europe with such a great numbers. Surprisingly, because if you look at the venture capital investments, Europe is having the same size of GDP as United States and being bigger than China, is only spending 0.13% of the GDP to the venture capital investments, being three times smaller from that perspective than US and China. That's really looks like that Europe is very efficient in building value and exiting value compared to China and US, or simply the European investors are keeping it shorter in their portfolios and exiting later to the global investors and strategic buyers. Looking at the growth of the venture capital, what we see is US is having the lowest growth, but also we have to remember that this market starts with also very high base 6 years ago. We present the last 6 years in these numbers. China is the fastest growing with almost 70% growth. I mean, Europe is slightly above US, but far, far below China. That basically also means something, and that will be the topic we'll be discussing in the first part of our panel. Looking at the regional split in terms of countries, we observe a couple of the high performing countries in European Union, which are producing the highest number of technology startups and successful unicorns, which is countries like Estonia, Sweden, Denmark, UK, Netherlands, Ireland, Estonia, and of course Israel. And there are also a couple of slow movers. I would say Italy, looking at the number of technology developers versus the number of successful unicorns, the number of startups per 100,000 inhabitants. Germany could do better. Also, we probably need to progress within the Polish market. But if you remember what was in Europe 10 years ago, there was one unicorn, no new development, like a desert. Right now we have more than 50 unicorns in Europe. There is a new 17 unicorns coming last year to the European market. That's a huge change and huge improvement. But let me discuss all these things together with our great panelists. We split our session into two groups, covering the general technology development and covering the financial and insurance development within Europe. Thank you.